Dr. Anna Becker, CEO of EndoTech, and very excited about this project. We are very excited about the start, very excited about how it's going right now, and please join it.
Dimitri, where are you calling from?
Hi everyone, it's Dimitri here, Dimitri Gushin, CEO at EndoTech, calling from Tel Aviv. Nice to meet you all.
And then we have Adam Rubin.
Nice to see you guys. I am a British man, but also out here in Israel, in Tel Aviv, joining you all this morning. Nice to see you all. Amazing to see so many people joining. Really fantastic.
Englishman, British man. But your name, Adam and Ruben, is a Jew. It's a full Jew.
It is about as Polish / Russian as you can get on the history side, yeah. But yeah, here I am, Mr. Worldwide. But glad to be with you guys. Nice to see you, Ed and Jeremy, Ilya. Good to be with you.
Then maybe Alexei. We have Alexei. Nobody probably knows who's Alexei, but he's a pretty big role in here too. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from a beautiful phone booth in Kiev, Ukraine. The weather is hell, but the booth is beautiful, isn't it?
Yeah.
And we have our guy, Daisy, background, Ilya, mining from nice and
yes,
warm.
Yeah, I am a Russian man, yeah, just like after Adam, you know, I feel that I need to say that. I'm a Russian man, but I'm calling from Thailand, from Pattaya, Thailand. Hi everybody.
I think we're Jeremy, we can start probably right.
All right. Welcome everybody, and let me hit the record button here. All right, great to have everybody joining us tonight, and we got a great call lined up for you, and looking forward to really hearing from the EndoTech team tonight. We also have Alex on the webinar with us tonight, who is going to be sharing some insight on the technology updates, and of course Edward and Ilya and myself. Great to be here with you guys, and we're just excited. I know it's everybody is waiting and ready for the platform to open back up, and I'll tell you what, it's going to be worth it. What we're going to do in this next wave of relaunch and the legacy company that we're going to build together with Daisy is like nothing we've ever seen. And we got a little taste of it on the 10th of January for a couple of days, but we know that the future is everything, even more than we had hoped for. As we've seen the project already start to unfold, we realize where we're going, what we're going to be scaling into, and it's going to be an empire legacy project, that's for sure. So, guys, I want to throw it over to my business partner, Edward Kemchen, who actually introduced me to EndoTech, to Adam, to Dr. Anna, to Dimitri, and you know, he really had the vision from day one for what EndoTech can do in the marketplace. And I remember Edward first telling me about EndoTech, and he said, listen, this is a company that has the technology to become a multi-billion dollar and beyond project, and we've got to figure out a way to bring this to the world, to really put a model together with EndoTech. And that was a year and a half ago. So it's exciting to see how things have come around full circle. And Edward, thanks for your mentorship, your friendship, and I'll throw it over to you.
Thank you, Jeremy. It is a pleasure being on this call. Thank you everyone for joining. Before I'm gonna go in, I actually want Ilya, as our partner, one of our founders, to say a few things, and then I want to complete something, because all this time since the last 2 weeks, our days are, I wake up, and the first thing I do, I talk to Ilya and Jeremy, and before I go to sleep, I talk to Ilya and Jeremy every single day. So I'm going to pass it to Ilya for now, and then Ilya, please pass it back to me.
Thank you, Edward, yes. And this is actually one of the reasons why I cannot see my family early morning, because I wake up very late because of this time difference. But I'm kind of enjoying this, and what I want to say is that actually I'm very, very humbled and very proud to surround myself with positive people. Because now we have some temporary issues, and all of people that you see on this call became very close friends of mine, not just partners. And I'm very happy to see on daily basis that everybody keeps very positive attitude. I believe that for long-term success, it's super, super important to stay positive. And this is actually the reason why we partnered initially with Edward, with Jeremy, actually, to launch this business, because we are on the same page, because we feel the same about long-term vision for this product. It's not a short-term business for just one month or couple months. So we have plans for many years to come, and it is extremely important to understand the vision. And I'm very happy that most of leaders of global leadership actually shares our vision. I mean, they agree on our vision. They follow this vision, and this is why we are on the call today, right? So, yes, we have some temporary issues, but everything is under control. So you're going to hear today from Dr. Anna about product side. You're going to hear from Mr. Alex from Kiev, from Ukraine. He's going to touch on some technical side as well. So everything is under control 100%. We stay not only positive, but very confident in long-term success. So, Edward, I'd like to pass back to you and please take it over.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. Anyway, same thing for me. It is my pleasure, and it's actually, I enjoy, even though we have some challenges, right? But I enjoy working with you guys, with all of you, right? And I know where we headed. We headed to somewhere very, very exciting. It's going to be really good. So the way everything started, actually, the very first guy who I spoke to with EndoTech, that was Adam Rubin. And Adam Rubin is here right now, and I wanted you guys, probably most of you seen him on the website. Some of you maybe heard a little bit from him, but Adam Rubin played a big role here. He's the one who, on the first call, he's the one who got me really interested about EndoTech and got my belief in him. He's the first guy I spoke, and he's the one who connected me with Dr. Ann and Dmitry Gushin. And Adam is actually going to be one of the guys who's going to be helping and connecting all the VIPs accounts. He's responsible, that's what he does. And I visit him in Israel. Him and Dmitry are very close. They are very, very close partners. I wanted actually from Adam himself, so you guys could hear exactly what they do behind the scenes. This is our executive team here from EndoTech. And Before I'll pass it to you, Adam, I want to say actually a few more things. Last 2 weeks, I've been talking to a lot of leaders from DAISY, and some excited because there's only a handful of people who made money so far, because we opened up only for 5 days, right? But I'm telling you guys, we didn't even start it. What you've seen, it's such a small thing what you've seen. You didn't even see when the trading is going to start. This is why we have Dr. Anna here. We wanted you guys to actually understand the behind the scene, the foundation of DAISY. And if you see it, our pay setters bonuses and people who actually reached those bonuses and made a little bit on it, and it was exciting because that was a lot more than they expected, right? But nobody didn't even realize that the pay setter, it was only front money. It didn't even, the trading profits didn't even start it. Right? I do have a lot of people asking me questions right now. Recently, in the last few days, people start asking me questions. When is the trading going to start? Is it why it didn't start it yet? Well, that's why we have Dr. Anna here. She's going to actually tell you when it's going to start. It actually starts from the day you guys purchase the tier. It starts. Maybe first 10 days, 2 weeks, 2 months. Maybe there's nothing you're going to see it. But then you'll see it. I mean, this is the real trading. Anyway, so I think Adam, Ruben, first I want to tell directly to you, I want to thank you for bringing this to us, because it started with you. You were the guy that first I spoke with, and if you did not connect me, if I didn't believe in you, we would not be here today. So Adam, thanks again. Please.
It's a wonderful thing to have an introduction like that. It's an even more wonderful thing to have these words coming from people that I genuinely have so much loyalty to and honor and respect for. So Ed, right back at you. Ilya, you know, I've had less time with you, but it's been absolutely phenomenal. Jeremy, you know how I feel about you. I think you're fantastic. And that energy of yours is just infinite, which I can respect very much, because I have to tap in to those same infinite wells of energy to always make sure that, you know, our clients and our system and our team and our partners are feeling precisely the things they need to feel. I'll give myself a really short intro here. I'm Adam Rubin. I am VP of Sales for EndoTech as a company, and I'm originally from the UK, from London. I've been living out here in Israel since 2008. That's when I moved out here for new opportunities for technology. My background is in the field of financial trading and market analysis. I've always been a bit of a markets junkie, and luckily I've been able to build up a good reputation in the field of financial consulting and financial technology providing. But this also meant that I'm sure most of you are aware that there's lots of negative aspects of the online market. There are a lot of traps out there. There's lots of problems just waiting for you to find for the first time. And I have a very, very pure soul where what's most important to me is how I feel and who I represent myself as a father, as a husband, in my community, in my industry. I take it very, very personally and primarily. So I always stayed away from working with any others. This enabled me to build up some good assets. And then I ran into crypto. And this is just a really quick story so that you can understand why both Anna and Dimitri are not just business partners, they're my family, and why this lean family team is about to change the entire market together. So very simply, the problem with crypto is that it's highly volatile, great opportunity, but very big risks. I personally bought in at the wrong time with too much funds, too much risk, it was out of control. I bought Bitcoin for the first time in January 2018. Hands up, I am the chimpanzee of the market. I'll put my other hand up because the next thing that I did was start to sell the BTC to altcoins because, of course, the dollar value was falling. So I'm going home telling my wife, don't worry, it's under control. I'm buying Tron and EOS and Dash. You know, I'm trying frantically to find the 5,000% gain to get myself out the hole, and it was going badly. And I had a great friend introduce me to Dimitri here in the Diamond District, also where the EndoTech office is. Long story short, I sat down with Dimitri, there was a chemistry. He's a legitimate, genuine man. He cares about his family, his team, and every pixel, and I respect that. And he said three words to me: Adam, client, custody. And that was all I needed to hear, because we all should know these days, you know, when it comes to these systems, that's really where the attention was. From there, the team showed me their breakout systems of automation. I got to know Anna. It's been a fantastic journey. I promised that I would bring my friends from other hedge funds and the institutional industry, and we did. We took on retail, we took on markets that run healthy, and we've been doing this with a transparent technology that delivers our results in real time. And when we grew this friendship, Ed and guys, you know, I was so massively chuffed when Ed flew out to see us just before Corona. Nature loved us. The final trip that he managed to take was out here to Israel to see us and the team, and I'll never forget that investment. So when it comes to Daisy, very simply, from myself as a young 35-year-old looking to take over the universe and be the next Elon Musky Rubin, I want you all to know something, that it's not the money that's driving us, it's who we are and how we're doing it. We're fortunate enough to have the luxury in life where we can choose the projects that we want to work on, that we can choose the direction of this world that we want to go in. And both Anna and Dimitri are two of the most absolutely honest, fantastic, and straight and narrow people I've ever met. I've trusted them with my family, with my funds, with my career for the last 2 years. It's been the best decision I've ever made. And I'm looking forward to seeing the fruits of both of their pinnacle career moments. Daisy, as Edward said, has only just started. It hasn't really even been turned on. I hope to come and bring maximum value for the VIP accounts for all of you. I would like to bring perfect service, care, support, and make sure that you get all optimum efficiency from the best of our tech. And then with that in mind, I'd like to pass the mic over, I think, to Dimitri will say something now, but thank you so much for the opportunity, everyone. And I do thoroughly look forward to taking over the world with you one day at a time. Thank you so much for the patience also.
Thank you very much, Adam. It's a pleasure to meet you all, and thank you for the opportunity to speak with you today, guys. It's very important. First of all, I would like to remove completely any rumors concerning that the trading has not begun for Daisy yet. That's not the case. The first position for Daisy went live on January 18th, and any prior transaction was due to convergence, actually. And I believe that Anna will explain about it in details shortly. As Adam said, you know, as the crypto markets are extremely volatile, our main focus is invested both into the future results and account preservation methods for our clients' funds to rely on. As it stands today, our company has a multi-year head start against any potential competition. Both myself, Anna, and our full senior team, we are united in our mission to be part of the next wave of trading technology with, of course, our super intelligence DAISY project. Guys, my style is to say less and deliver more. So for now, thank you once again for the time and attention. And we, of course, look forward to working with you, you know, creating together our successful future with DAISY. Thank you very much. I think that, Anna, you should explain now about some details about trading.
I actually will speak more because it's very important for me to explain what's going on. It's important for me to explain the details and bring the reality of current and DAISY situation so you will understand the story. Let me share my screen. I appreciate if you can say that you see it, right?
Yeah, we can see it. Everybody can
okay.
see it.
So it's a kind of official report of up to January 29th of what happened. So I will start with Tron conversion story. What happened with the beginning of the uploading of the funds is that we started to receive the funds, and our thinking was as following. The algorithms that we utilize to convert Tron were as following. Even that at this point, all of our system indicated that it's kind of end of a bullish trend for Tron. We still were a little bit inclined to think that it might the onboarding of the clients for DAISY might artificially increase value of the Tron and then have a very short, sharp drop down of the pricing once the initial wave will end. So we decided to use algorithm that will keep only 10% and will not try to be advantageous with the system. So during the first 2 days, as you can see, market experienced 15% of the Tron price decreases, and then it resulted in 2-3%, depending on the account, of the losses of the total conversion. Now, just to explain it, it's not really a big problem for us because we're talking about high risk, high return. And in high risk, high return, if you remember, our goal is to reach 100% and up. So any percentage which is single digit is expected and is managed. So for us, it's not a dramatic situation. So that's how it started. During the next few days, we were still converting Trons. And now we have everything converted to USDT. And from this, the trading started. So how it started? We started on January 4th, which is somewhere here, right in the middle. So what happened is that all of our clients, VIP clients, EndoTech, experienced 60% trend on Ether, where we made the full value of the trend, and also experienced the second trend of almost 100%, where we took 75 to 80% of the trend. So after this situation, which was very successful up to 4th of January, all of our algorithms said that it's actually very high risk zone begins and thus no trading. What it means is that if you look at the changes that were during this period, for several times it went very abruptly up and down, even up to 50%. So if you're taking the wrong side because you're thinking that it's a trend going down and you're taking the sell side, you're taking the sell signal, then you might experience extremely big losses, even with stop losses. So during this situation, we simply say, don't trade. We wait for our indicators, system indicators, to say that volatility reduced, and now we can start trading. So till 18th of January, all of our indicators said no, don't trade. And I'm happy to report that it was a right decision. And you can see now, it was a right decision to do. From January 18th, we started to trade. Now the volatility is still very high from our point of view. Only now it starts to get, even not today, into the normal volatility. So the volatility where we can expect trends, right? So from our point of view, we started to trade very with minor funds, with only few out of 40 strategies that we have. And we experienced some wins, some losses. Eventually, as you can see on your screens on Daisy, we took another 2% of hit. But again, it's a very dangerous situation, and 2% of losses is very accepted and actually welcomed from my side, because if it's during the months you experience 2% during this period, it means that systems are right where they're supposed to be. So the good stories that happened is that some of you that not experienced the trading short, we had several short algos kicking in, a little bit saving the situation. So for example, on Bitcoin, we entered short on 35, exited on 33, took again break even short, resulting in, again, saving a bit of the results. Also, we had swing algos on Ether that entered with sell at 14.17, and also resulting right now in a small wins. And altogether, we are now at a 5-6% loss, again, single digits. We are still where it's supposed to be after such massive trends that happened on the market. When I speak about Daisy portfolio, I would like to introduce to you our portfolio. We have 40 plus strategies that running. Their breakdown, their allocation is between Bitcoin, Ether, altcoins, and Tron. Again, Tron is a historical situation for the Daisy at the moment. We have 41% in Ether, just because it's shown to be much more volatile and resulting in very high trends. So our breakdown is Ether 41, Bitcoin almost 30, 28. Altcoins altogether responsible for 18%, and Tron right now responsible for 13%, which should reside as soon as we start new onboarding. It should be go down to 3%. Also, this situation is just because we just started, so later more will flow into the Bitcoin. From the trend swing situation, 80% are relying on the trend. So 20% of the swing are hedging us exactly in the situation that we are right now, to reduce a little bit of the drawdowns during choppy periods. We are right now in extremely choppy period of the market. So again, we need this help of the swing algos. We are relying basically this year on the buy side. That's what says algos to us. But of course, we need our sell side as well. Our sell side is more aggressive because we're using more of the leverage on that side. So even that is 35-65, you can trust that if we experience short markets, it will be fairly 50-50 situation on the execution. But right now, again, we are more relying on the buy side in ratio-wise. So this is a story of Daisy. Again, everything started from the day one, the conversion side. Then algos were waiting for the entry, and now that's what you see. You can see it in your Daisy screen under the fund, and it's updated regularly, and you will see different results between different contributors, because you entered at different points, and the conversion story that I showed at the beginning was different for each client. So that's what happened.
Anna, maybe you will add a couple of words about the audition as well.
Yes, we are planning audition. We are getting ready to it. Probably we will not be able to do audition at the end of the January for our training, but by end of February, it should be full detailed audition with one of the top five companies. And all the trades will be provided to the audit companies. They will check, cross-check our exchange accounts through this trade, through the result that we publish, and we'll put their stamp of approval. So this is very important for us because, again, we are fully aware that we are in high-risk, high-return markets. So there is no free cheese. We will experience losses. We will need to show that we are comfortable with these losses, we understand these losses, and we are accountable for these losses. So this transparency help us to stay true to the field of high-risk, high-return, and not to try kind of any other approach.
I think, everyone, if I can just add one final last bit of texture for this, because I was a young, aggressive, alpha, super risky style trader, and I've come into this company, and here we have these very emotionless, automated algorithms that are working. And of course, as a manual freestyle trader, I'm always thinking about opportunities to long, short, and what have you. The key to this technology is the ability to have the experience to provide the time required. This is the only further investment that anyone would need with Daisy with regards to gaining benefit over time. It's the investment over time. So these algorithms and these structured trading strategies will produce statistical performance over time. And this statistical performance has really been the lifeblood of this team. That's our academic market proven pedigree. That is where the pedigree comes from. It's from years of staying constant, not consistent, constant. And the way that we're going to stay constant is precisely as Anna said, and as the team have advised, we're going to take the tech to the next level. We're in a high-risk, high-reward market. It's fully automated running as it should be. And if all of you can provide the patience for the machines to take the positions that they need to take, we will gain the statistical outcome that we're after. But we can't rush the machines because they're not like us. They're looking for those technical opportunities, and they will take those positions as and when is correct to take them. So it may be a few days or a few weeks between positions. We may have singular trades that run for weeks at a time. It's not here to show off like a managed FX trader would, for example. So I'll just leave it there, and I'm really excited for all of you to start really feeling these results after 90 days, 120 days, you start seeing some averages. That's what we should be hunting for, everyone. Looking for the end of the first and second quarter and really understanding the shape of the annual term that we're covering as this first year rolls out for Daisy.
That's a really good point, Adam, you brought. I don't know if you remember when I got Connect My Account, remember, back in 2018?
Yeah, every week or so, is it connected? Is everything okay? What's happening?
Yes, 2 weeks, calling you and say, Adam, are you sure my account is connected? I have zero trades, right? And you go like, don't worry, it's connected, you know? And then what happened? Five trades in a row. No, five trades. My first five trades, they were losing trades.
Oh, correct. May. Yeah.
Yeah. And then later, my account quadrupled. I mean, it's over time. It wasn't quadrupled.
We don't know if it's going to be the winning month or losing month. Here's the game. Let's say that it's the first month that you start and you immediately start in profit. You feel like you're $1 billion. We're the smartest man in the world. But if you start on a negative month, the little old voices start to pipe up. Oh, am I in the right place? Did I make the right decision? Is it even working? My friend is calling me and telling me he's making 8,000% last night in 3 minutes. What am I doing? Just remain calm. And I think I'll pass it back off, but having someone like Alexi on the team and also Ed, you and Jeremy and Ilya, the way that you're able to distribute the correct educational message for everyone to use this system, we really are relying on everyone to stay unified. And if we do, Ed, how do you feel after a couple of years of results with us? Is it good? Is it bad? we're back for round two, right? So I'm wishing for everyone the same. And it may take more or less time, depending on if the first month is the positive month or not. Yeah.
Dr. Anna, a couple more questions to you, and then I think we'll go into a little bit direction with Jeremy. question first, before I go more into question first, the last couple of days, so many people called me, the people who already bought 10 tiers waiting for VIP. Do we have approximate date when VIP program is going to be ready for DAISY members?
We're doing final testing of the front-end technology, and next week we will finalize it. It's not a big story, so next week we will give the call for the VIP accounts, and Adam will, you know, welcome them into the infrastructure.
Awesome, very good. The most common question I hear from the field, people are asking, how is EndoTech able to execute larger orders when all exchanges do not have a way to execute large trades, large?
Again, we are coming from the field of commodities trading. We traded on highly liquid, less liquid. We treated thousands of clients. And what we understood that you need to have professional, high-grade institutional order execution. So the thing that we did fairly early, we also suffered in 2018 from the poor execution of the exchanges. So what we did is we put the emphasis on algo execution of the orders. So each order that comes into the system has a specific algorithm of how to execute it. For the professionals on this calls, I will explain it in a simple way. You have level 2 book, you have TVAP, VVAP orders. So we created our own smart algorithms that actually takes into account the order flow that we need to execute, and we use our own proprietary algorithms for order execution. Again, relying on the level 2 on the book and on the different exchanges. We spread between different exchanges, we spread between time, and so on. There are two additional values that play into our favor. The reason that we don't use high frequency trading is specifically because of this, because we believe that you cannot be highly active in such markets as crypto, because again, you need more liquidity. So our algorithms are more of the long term. We don't take many trades, and whenever we take a trade, we have enough time to enter. We don't enter at the break, we enter before the break. So before the break, you usually have enough time to enter in specific algorithms. So this is one. And then also when we exit before the opposite direction take place. So during this 20% of the trend, you still have lots and lots of places where to exit. So again, proprietary algos, we try to use proprietary algos of different exchanges. We discuss it with their teams, with their institutional teams. And apparently their results is about, like, you know, 3 to 8 times worse than what we have. So we decided to stick to our development, to stick to what we have. We're still looking, we're still weekly discussing it with different teams, whether they can offer us additional elements of improving the algos. But at the moment, again, we're still with our execution. Our estimation is this, that we will not be affected till $480 million in under management for the DAISY. After that, again, we're constantly looking. So probably till we get there, we will be able to offer even higher market cap, higher AUM cap for the trading. And I'm not talking about additional markets, just the crypto.
Adrian, you also mentioned that with the multi-year head start, Ed, and that's really what's so critical. Anna gave us the complete technical side, so I'll just give you the slightly fundamental emotional side. Becoming close to modern and high-level trading exchanges is not an easy task in today's world. There's a lot of people that would like to be very, very closely friends with the Winklevoss twins over at Gemini Exchange, or the owners of Binance, or Arthur Hayes, for example, at BitMEX. Over the last few years, even before I was here, the team were dedicating relationship building with the major exchanges. And today we have a very strong direct connection to the senior management, not only at Binance, but also at exchanges that are world renowned for their services, such as Gemini, who publicly support and endorse us for our institutional deployment. So along with our algorithmic abilities, these exchanges are enjoying the fact that we are bringing them thousands of clients that stay healthy for years at a time, that generate beautiful trading volume for those exchanges. So this is a great benefit for all of you. You get to jump on the back of many years of relationship building and close building with the actual people who run these exchanges, so that if ever there is a problem, or where Anna says we hit a part of the funnel where 480 or 500 million, we start to have some execution headaches, we can pick up the phone and get immediate service as you would want us to have. So that's a real big added benefit there that we will all benefit from as we continue.
Thank you, Adam, for clarification. You know, even though we're still being fully launched, I can say this team is already working on bringing different markets. We're already working to get a registered fund fully working between me, Jeremy, Ilya, Dimitri, and Dr. Anna. We've been working to bring different markets as Forex, but we'll talk about that later. The last question to you, Dr. Anna, to Dimitri, either I'm not sure exactly who's going to answer this question, but I know we've been working, all of us, my partners, you guys in the tech, we've been working around the clock. Dimitri messaged me at past 4 a.m. this morning, messaged me a few things and then good night. I'm thinking, like, you need to get up pretty soon. You're telling me good night, right? So we all don't sleep. We work hard. I mean, you can see Adam. He has this eye circles. I'm looking at him. Did he cry or did he not sleep? I'm not sure, right? Anyway, but the question, coming back to the question, the application that EndoTech took over, the one actually started acting and not worked out for us immediately the day we launched. The second we launched, it didn't work, right? And now you guys took it into your hands and your team, right? And I want to hear it from you. How is that going in that direction? If you can, I know Jeremy can add some things as well to it. But I mean, this is another question from the field. I want to put this last question, then we move to Jeremy to you.
Yes, the application is, as you see, it's functioning. We are planning to upgrade it with more information about the fund. So you will see more of the interworkings of the trading and of the fund. You will see more about your own trading results, your own part of the contribution fund. So again, from our point of view, it's already working. If you see any issues, of course, it needs to be reported. It's very new application for us. So again, if there are any issues unnoticed, please report it. Otherwise, from our point of view, it's becoming stable. It's becoming, it's not causing issues. So let's move forward with this one.
All right. Awesome. One more question, Dr. Anna, I forgot. White paper. Can you tell us about white paper?
Yeah, white paper. It's our infamous 2 week story. We are working on this with right now since the DAISY was already started, and we were able to deploy to work with professors and doctors on PhDs on artificial intelligence, on economics and things like that. So they all started to put their teeth into our white paper and give us comments. So we need another time to make sure that we do everything properly. Again, DAISY was a vision, to take it from vision to exact scientifically rigorous story. That's our goal, to be really scientifically rigorous about our research, because I think nobody took this on themselves to build the story, which is not only the vision, but actually the world changing, the industry changing story. It takes us time to make sure that we're moving into the right direction on every element. So again, even that, I would very much like to tell you that next week we will see it, hopefully, but give us a little bit more time to finalize it. I get lots of requests and calls from universities and students saying that they're also doing some PhD or master's thesis on fintech, on finance, on economy or something, whether we can help them with data, we can help them with information or with artificial intelligence element. We can, yes, we will do that, but let us first do our job for the next few months to prepare all this infrastructure for you. And then we will gladly work with you on all the elements that we need. Again, the more the merrier from this point of view. So again, white paper, hopefully this week, more realistically week after.
Awesome. Ilya and Jeremy, do you guys have any questions for Dr. Anna, for Dmitry from the field here? We're probably missing something here.
No, you nailed my questions.
Yeah, I believe you asked all the questions. Just regarding this white paper, Dr. Anna, some people asking this question, whether it's going to be very difficult to read for those people who are not into science or something. How,
yes,
like, is it going to be 100
yes.
pages or 1,000 pages?
It will not be long, but it will be intense. So again, if you are not part of the field, we will not cut corners on the terminology. It will be kind of overview. We're not trying to build the answers. White paper is not about answers, it's about questions. We will put the questions, we will put the methodologies that we're planning to use, we will put the necessary information about start of the project. It's not about, again, it will not be a scientific paper yet, it will be more of the overview and our direction of how we're taking it. If you are not accustomed to a very detailed overview, it will probably will not be for you. We want to make a statement for, scientists. We want to make a statement for AI programmers of where we're going. And that should be exciting kind of for them to read our paper. So on the, it's not popular paper. I mean, maybe very much at the beginning, the first executive summary will be readable. After that, we're not making this as a goal. And this was my specific instructions that, again, we want to change the world. We don't want to, entertain at this point. So once we reach initial results, we will start to entertain, I promise, because for me, it's very important for people to understand what technology is able to bring to their life, not only the end result of making successful trading and making successful bottom line, but also the result of understanding. We call it deep reasoning. We want to show that technology able to bring you the deep reasoning and able to help you understand the world better. But again, we will start entertaining later. Right now, it's just a pure, blood and
okay.
Work.
Change the
okay.
world. This is the goal of DAISY. We will change the world. There's going to be hundreds and hundreds of thousands of people with great testimonials. Guys, EndoTech executives, Dr. Anna, Dmitry, and we thank you so much. We're honored to work with you. Looking forward for a long journey, successful journey with you guys. And now I want to pass it to my friend, to my business partner, Jeremy Roma. The announcements about smart contract, a lot of people waiting now. Let's move to that direction, if that's right.
Absolutely. Yeah, what an incredible call. Thank you guys again so much for being with us tonight. The model of DAISY, because of the partnership with EndoTech and the long-term vision of this model. I mean, it ties into this next part of the conversation because, one of the things that we constantly have to, we have to be looking at every scenario from two perspectives, from the short-term immediate perspective, but also from the long-term scaling perspective as we go into phase two and phase three of the different elements of DAISY, as you've seen in our roadmap. So one of the things that has come up in this process, and I love, Edward, you say this all the time, that things always end up working in our good. And even things that look bad somehow have the ability to produce forward movement, right? Necessary things come out of sometimes those negative challenges. I think we would all agree that if we had to choose where we were right now, we would wave a magic wand and we never would have had these issues with the initial platform. right? If we could go back in time and do things differently, absolutely, we would all choose to be in a different situation. But as it turns out, the situation that we're in is actually serving a very big purpose for the future of Daisy. Because what it forced us to do and is it forced us to bring in the top of the top, brilliant minds when it comes to smart contracts, blockchain technology, decentralized applications, and get all of these different views on the architecture of our internal technology. And in that deep dive process, in fact, this is how we ended up meeting Alex. We went back to an auditing company and said, look, we want to do a second audit on the platform, but we want to do it from a different perspective. We don't just want to do an audit to make sure the smart contract works. We want to do an architectural audit that makes sure that we're able to scale in the future. In other words, that we can upgrade our smart contracts to new offerings. Let's say, for example, we move into the Forex market next, and we have an offering, we have a different offering than we have today. We want to be able to maintain the entire genealogy, maintain the qualifications, and bring phase two to the community without even blinking an eye, literally be able to emerge into these future phases of Daisy. Well, some of that architecture was missing. Some of that ability to migrate into new generations of Daisy smart contracts was missing. The proxy server and some of the architecture that's required in order to create upgradable smart contracts and for us to be able to scale to millions of users and for Daisy to become anything that the market demands and it become in the future. So as EndoTech expands, as Daisy AI expands, as we move into different markets like Forex and equities, and as we move into the decentralized finance arena, which is in the future for Daisy, big DeFi projects are in the future for us. We needed the ability to move that genealogy and that infrastructure, rather maintain that infrastructure in genealogy, but create new smart contracts that can tie in the future. So we found out in this process that there were some things at a core level of the technology that were missing. And the truth is right now we had to hit the pause button with 55,000 people. And we have to migrate from one smart contract, and Alex will talk a little bit about this tonight. Initially, we thought it was going to be three smart contracts that we were going to divert into. And now, after full analysis, it's going to be five different smart contracts that are all talking to each other. There'll be a smart contract for pay setters, for example. There'll be a smart contract for the trading rewards, for example. And there'll be different smart contracts operating different elements and components of the logic. This came as a result of Alex and a team and other teams of top leaders. So what we've done, guys, is we have now brought in specific field experts in each area that we have a problem in that we need a solution for. The data log solution, that's been solved. The smart contract solution has been solved. What I want everyone to hear today, I think, is two things. And I want to introduce Alex so you can hear his perspective as the lead technology consultant for Daisy. Every situation that we ran into in the first launch, the solutions, those solutions were uncovered within days, and the development has started on those solutions. In the process, we also realized there were some bigger architectural concerns that would have limited our ability to scale in the future. So yes, right now we had to hit the pause button with 55,000 members that joined in 4 days. But if this had not happened, we would have had to figure out a solution in 30 days with a million users. And we would have had to hit the pause button literally maybe for months on end if we would have let the problem grow to that degree before we addressed it. So in one sense, nobody would choose to be in this situation right now. But on the other hand, this temporary situation is actually putting Daisy in the very position that we need to, that we deserve to be in, where we have the ability to scale, unlimited scaling for the future of Daisy. And so in order to achieve that goal, you know, I asked Alex this week, we were, you know, a lot of the programs happening. I said, what is the, what is your realistic expectation? And he said, well, we have two things. We have a short-term solution that's going to let Daisy come to the market quicker. He said, that's probably going to take up to 2 weeks. Could be sooner, but 2 weeks will allow it to be fully tested, fully developed. This is a temporary solution. In the process, over the next few weeks, we will create the underlying architecture for the long-term solution, but we'll be able to do a natural migration. We won't have to shut the system down in the future. We won't have to put anything on pause. We'll have a short-term solution in the next 2 weeks. And then from there, we will be able to lay that long-term infrastructure that we need in order to be able to scale. So Alex, I love your story because you were introduced to Daisy actually through one of the auditing companies that we are working with. They have a tremendous respect for you and your company that you own, your development company that you own, and you have tremendous respect for them when it comes to being the number one auditing company out there, one of the best. And you came to Daisy Project through a different perspective. So thanks for being with us, guys. Alex is actually now the lead technology consultant for Daisy, overseeing several teams around the world with different areas of development and really helping us have a technology perspective on everything that's happening as well while the development's taking place. So Alex, thanks for being with us tonight, man. I'll throw it to you.
Thanks, Jeremy. So I think the proper thing would be to first introduce myself. I'm Alex. I have a development company, and I'm going to tell you my perspective, my angle, how it's all came to be, and how Daisy handles this problems and how it resolves everything. So a few weeks back, Daisy requested first audit, and audit pointed to some of the potential scalability issues. But not a single person expected this inflow of users. So the interest was tremendous, and the system, the load on the system was too much. And Daisy team, what they did, they reacted. They said, like, we need to compile a team of specialists right now. And Alex is actually not a one person, right? It's a person behind a team of guys with prior smart contract development experience. So it's a conclave of people. And well, we started to think from that point to handle the potential issues. Now, why I personally state, why I like guys? Well, there are two main reasons. First, their dedication. So during the time when they try to tackle this honestly hardship, they asked for a second, I don't know how to call it, a real-time audit. So this auditing company, it's a topmost company, so it takes a lot of funds. It takes a big dedication to constantly keep them here to oversee how things are progressing and how things are going. And the second thing that I really liked is a product. So we all know the 2020-2021, right, the trends of the market. And we see constantly a new DeFi pops up with new token, with the funky tokenomics, and then they disappear or they do something. Now, why I was really attracted to Daisy? It's actually a straight up technology. So there is no funky scheme. We have it everywhere. Here is the technology. Here's how we trade. You participate in our program. That's it. That's all we care about. And well, making a new technology is always much more complicated than introducing a token that utilizes something else that was done previous, right? It indicates the investments. It indicates the long term. I think that's it for an introduction, right? And I should point out to a solutions on how we tackling these issues and how we are gonna deliver everything soon. So what's the underlying issue? Well, there are two, as Jeremy pointed out. One thing, the Pacesetter program. There were a lot of Pacesetters, man. So that part needs to be engineered from another perspective. There are mathematical patterns on how you are able to do that on-chain, and you would be able to do it. So you just wait. And the second is matrix genealogy. So if we think about the number of users and the number of operations, there are things like sums of geometric progressions. There are exponential functions that we need to handle and optimize carefully when we talk about context of our smart contracts. So this team that we've compiled, it's partly scientists and partly experienced smart contract developers that all handling this issue and tackling and making this this product in a way that's a scalable long-term solution. First, it's 100% possible to do. How are we doing it? Well, we are gonna create a new smart contract that's first gonna migrate all of the users. And by the way, I believe that the migration actually might be the biggest issue here. So yeah, the research guys would be able to just optimize stuff. Perhaps there would be some minor tweak and catch and problem would be solved like so. But problem about straight up data and bandwidth that we got previously, like the 55,000 people with all of their referral users, with, it's a tremendous recursive structure. And approach on how to resolve that, and the process must be done really carefully and up to standards. So I cannot promise you a expect us within a 2 days statement. I'm gonna say that this would take at least 2 weeks, as Jeremy pointed out, and please excuse me, Jeremy, because I'm repeating some of the stuff that you already said. I just want to highlight it and address it and perhaps address why so. Even though we may be potentially done with this intermediate solution within a week, we would not launch it. We would basically audit it. We would quality assure. We need to set up a high-low test cases and see how our system behaves and simulates the high loads. Afterwards, we would greenlight everything and we would tell you, now we're ready. And now it's a real usable product that's ready for all of you guys. That's it for me. Perhaps there are some questions that I may address.
I think it's awesome. You know, it's yeah. Important. I think it's really important for everyone to understand. You know, we're so thankful for the teams that have come together, because when we went into this initially, we had development teams on each part of the project, and if there was one mistake that was made, that was probably it. Was that we had too many teams doing too many different things instead of one team that was organized and structured to bring everything together. So now moving forward, and guys, this is I think what's really important to understand. So I want everyone to be very clear. We're looking at 2 weeks from today. And look, the last 10 days, a lot of work has been done. The database, all of that has been extracted from the smart contract. The new contracts have started to go under development. Much progress has been made. But we cannot have this mistake again. And if it takes 2 weeks, if it takes 4 weeks to have a rock solid platform that is able to scale with us into the billions of dollars where we're going with Daisy, then it's worth it. We, as leaders, every one of you on the call today, You're a leader. You're a founder. You're a pioneer. You're someone who saw the vision of Daisy before anyone else in the marketplace did. And when we reopened the doors of Daisy, every single member that has the 55,000, 53,000 members that joined Daisy in those first 4 days, you get to be a part. You will get to be a part of the biggest organized launch that the market has ever seen. And there's a story that's unfolding right now, guys. It's a pretty epic story. We did some amazing things in those first 4 days with a broken platform. We're launching a technology company and our technology failed. This is a beautiful story as long as we finish the story. It's a beautiful story that says sometimes when you dare to do what has never been done, you're going to face challenges and have lessons learned and have to go through some growing pains. If you play it small, you don't have to have these issues. If you do what's already been done, this is an easy way to live life. Doing what has already been done, you just take a copy of what already exists, it's already been proven, and you just put your color of paint on it. But when you're a pioneer, when you're an innovator, like EndoTech is innovating with the Daisy trading technology and their current trading algorithms, when you're innovating the way the Daisy Global Project has innovated a disruptive smart contract business model, when you're doing things that have never been done, you can expect to face challenges you've never had to face before. The beautiful story about Daisy is still being written. And part of that story is we have a community of 55,000 people. We have a core group of thousands of leaders that see the vision with us. We're going to lead through the challenges, the delays. We're going to get organized together. And we're going to release the biggest second launch that we've ever seen. All 53,000 members, your position remains, your genealogy remains, your qualifications remain, your 30 days is reset, your 48-hour for 10 generations is reset. Even if you've already gotten paid for those 48 hours, you're going to get it again. All of that's in place. We're going to organize and launch in a way that you will have absolute confidence and absolute certainty that the platform is working. And so we've got a great strategy, a great roadmap lined up, but we want to be very realistic. We hoped that we would have launched a week ago. The deeper we dug into the problems, the more we realized we can't ignore this. We can't ignore this. These things have to be done the proper way in order for us to go where we're going as a project. And if that's what it takes, then that's what it takes. And what we're asking all of you as leaders is to put your leadership hat on with us. Put your pioneer hat on with us. I promise you, there's none of you that are watching this webinar, I promise you, that are more disappointed or have had to deal with more frustration over this process than all of us have. Because you got to realize that you know, this is months of our lives vested into this project, years of our lives leading up to this project. This is 20 hours a day, 7 days a week that we have poured into this. And if, trust me, we know what it feels like to say, oh my God, I can't believe this just happened. What it feels like to think that you've perfectly prepared only to find out that you haven't. And so we understand the disappointments and the frustrations. But we also understand that this is where great treasures are created. And through great challenges comes great character, comes great culture, comes great community. And as a community, we can use this as something that brings us together and says, I was one of the ones that saw the vision, that never stopped believing in Daisy, even though we had challenges along the way. And I went to work during the pause to prepare for the reopening. And I was one of the ones who didn't give up. And because of that, this is the reward. When we open Daisy back up, we will be the fastest project to 1 million distributors all day long. We've already broken every first week record of any company in the history of peer-to-peer marketing ever in the first week. When we reopen, I believe we're going to break first year records in 30 days. I believe we will break 12-month records, and we'll do it in 30 days from the launch. So if it takes the full 2 weeks for us to be ready, if it takes longer than that for us to be ready, our promise to you is that it is absolutely going to be worth it. And I think the most amazing thing to wrap this up on my part tonight, for everyone to understand, and this is totally hypothetical. Alex, I want the people to hear you say that every problem we had, the solution is now in our hands, and it's now being put together. Is that an accurate statement? That there's no problem that is not already solved?
Absolutely. It just takes time. That's it.
So we are launching. We're relaunching. But hypothetically, if Daisy never opened its doors again, every single member that has contributed to Daisy is in a position to win. Because the power of the EndoTech trading platform, listen, you have stock equity. You have equity in this project, in EndoTech. You have access to this institutional level trading rewards. This happens even if no new money ever came into Daisy, the residual income from the long-term results of the trading, all of these benefits, absolutely, absolutely incredible. So with that being said, guys, you know, it's a tough announcement to make that we're not there yet, but I'll tell you what, it's absolutely going to be worth it. So Edward, Ilya, I'll throw it back over to you guys.
Yes, Jeremy. Like I like to say, I believe in this statement a lot. In my lifetime, a lot of things happen, and at that moment I thought it's bad, but it turned out for the best. And I know and I can see how this turning out for the best. These 2 weeks, people can use those 30 days extra. You already started enrolling some people. Maybe you brought 3 people, 4, 5, 6, 10, whatever you brought. Now you starting over with already having those people with you, right? So you're so much ahead. And if you already reached pay setter bonus, well, you have people in your team who didn't, and now you can help them to reach those shares, because pay setters, those pay setters gold, when you have your 3 and or your 6 and 9, that's a lot bigger money than we all thought. I was surprised to see those right there bigger. So guys, 100%, this is for the best from both sides. It's for the best for the team. It's for the best for the company from a technical side to get prepared. And it just wait and see when the trading starts, when the profits are starting from trading. I'm excited. I'm excited. I'm 100% putting all my 100% a day. Like I said, I wake up, it's you guys. I go to sleep, it's you guys. It's like there's nothing else. It's just it's been like this. Ilya, let's finish the call with you.
Yes. I think that's been our lifestyle for the last few weeks, right? So from the moment we wake up until the moment we go to bed, actually, we are here to help you guys. We are also here to provide the best solutions. And like Jeremy said, like you, Edward, said, so I believe this will eventually turn into a very, very positive situation for everybody, right? So I think it would be very wise, actually, to use this period of time. Let's put it this way. For example, we have a couple of weeks, right? So many, many things can be done. Period of couple weeks, right? So we can do some trainings on the product side. We can invite Dr. Anna maybe one more time, right, to do some more explanation on the product side. Or maybe discuss a little bit AI technology, for example, right? Also, we can do some trainings on the pay plan, right? And now we are working on the, like I said last time, so we're working on translation. It's being done right now in multiple languages. We also added a couple languages, by the way. So it's gonna be Hindi language, it's gonna be Indonesian language, it's gonna be Portuguese, which is very important. Many leaders ask for Portuguese language. We also had some fancy slide about the explanation for 10 metrics, because we do have basically 10 metrics. Some people, they missed out on this, right? So it's very important to take advantage of this period of couple weeks, let's say, and just do some trainings. And we are here for you 24 hours a day to provide any kind of support needed. So we do leaders calls on daily basis. I mean, this is what we do. So I believe the future is very, very bright for all of us. Just like I'm based in Thailand, so every day, you know, the skies in this country is very, very shiny, and you see the sun. So unlike back in my country in Russia, so it's not gloomy here. So I believe that in the future we all we will see this kind of brightness, like I see in the Kingdom of Thailand. So the future is very, very bright. So let's just stay positive and train our teams and prepare for DAISY 2.0 that, like Jeremy mentioned, is going to be much, much more powerful, much bigger than what we had today, what we had before.
And guys, I don't know if you noticed this, but you know, whenever we get together, something magical happens. I don't know if anyone's been looking at the market price while we've been speaking, but in the last hour, Bitcoin has risen from 32,000 all the way up to almost 37. Very interesting, our energies together. Everything I've heard on this call is phenomenal. I didn't get a lot of time to be on these calls with you, so I'm going to be quiet, but thank you so much for the time. It's been so awesome to sit with you today, and excited.
Yeah. Awesome. Hey, one more thing, guys. We've been so busy, we forgot even to post it, to announce it. We sponsored one of the biggest in Asia events, crypto event, that we forgot to mention to you. Guys, it's actually a pretty cool thing. We got in through our Japanese team leader who brought this to our attention. And Ilya, do you want to cover a little bit about this?
Yes, basically it's one of the biggest events with some major people, famous people, right, in this industry of I'm talking about crypto industry, of course, not about the MLM industry, right? We became one of the sponsors, I would say, in the last couple of days before the event started. So it's an honor for us to be on the website with our logo. So about 5,000 people actually expected to visit that event, mostly in Asia, but because it's in English, so I would say like from all over the world. And we will also plan for the future. I mean, I cannot share right now what we plan for the next few months to come, but we plan also to participate in this kind of events with much, much bigger numbers. And I think we will have some surprises also for the future. I mean, now I'm not in position to share what is waiting for the future, but we will make all we can in order to be up and dated, not only in the industry of MLM, which is very important industry for us, and we've been in this industry for many years, right? But also in crypto industry, in particular in the industry of DeFi, because now it's a hottest trend, just like Alex mentioned, smart contracts, DeFi. So this is an industry where we are operating on very big scale. So we believe in the next few months, a lot of people, a lot of experts will pay attention on what we are doing, right? So we just need to relaunch. And again, I believe, even this year, many, many things, positive things are waiting for us.
While you were talking, I just got a text message from one leader, and I think this text message, I can answer this, but I wanted to actually announce it on so everybody would hear it this while everybody from EndoTech here. The question is, does DAISY have exclusive relationship with EndoTech? Or in the future, will we see other new companies using EndoTech and become competition with DAISY? Yes, we do have exclusive DAISY. I mean, if you go to EndoTech website, you see they're partner up with DAISY. You see only DAISY. I can say yes and yes and yes, but I want maybe Dr. Anna Dimitri.
The very simplest one, I think the fastest one, because I take care of all the sales for the company. So very simply, this partnership has been 2 years in the making. We consider Ed and the partners family to us. We have all been moving in one direction for this. The last thing that we will ever allow to happen is the foundation of our relationship to be eaten out from underneath. Exclusivity is just as valuable as the technology and the results. And rest assured that DAISY is locked in as the exclusive partner. There will never, ever be another further strategic partner, competing system, or anything of those lines. And just in case there's a competing company that likes what we're doing and they think that they can step into the arena with us, do remember that we've got a 3 to 5 year head start with our execution, exchange, and tech. So hopefully you can all take that and take it as gospel without Anna or Dima needing to step in. I'm the gatekeeper.
I love you. I can't wait. I can't wait to have this event once this COVID a little bit goes down. Have a live event in Dubai, right, Jeremy?
Yes, I can't wait.
Adam, you guys all coming. It's gonna be exciting. Can't wait.
We're on a giving. As long as we can fly with it.
Yes, Jeremy, would you close the call so we could go back to work?
Absolutely. So guys, that's the updates. Again, it's going to be worth it. And Dan, we just want to thank you guys for all of you who are on this webinar, all of you who are watching this webinar and replay. We know that none of the success story that's been created would have happened if it wasn't for your belief in this project and your dedication to this project. We know that anything great in the future that we do, everything great in the future that we do as Daisy, we do it as a community, and it's because of each and every one of us working together, doing our part, and we just want to thank you guys and say it's going to be worth it. We know that we all hope to be live by now, but the delay is necessary, and it's going to be worth it, and we're going to continue to plow forward and get ready for an epic phase two launch. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, guys. Yep. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.